Welcome to the Spy Collection. This Anastasios and today's artifact is relatively modern. It's a commercially available covert GPS tracking device which has been extensively used worldwide for surveillance purposes. The TK-102. You can find those devices under several brand names across the world, but the actual manufacturer of all of them is a single Chinese company called Coban Electronics based in Shenzhen. This company has been manufacturing commercial GPS trackers in large quantities since 1999, and the device we are looking at today, the TK-102, is based on a Coban patent from 2009. The device is pretty straightforward, and even on its package, we are reading that one of its usages is covert criminal tracking. Actually, in the intelligence community, those kinds of technologies have a name. They are called TTL. TTL stands for Tag, Track and Locate, and as their name implies, they are used in covert operations to tag, track and locate a target. In terms of accessories, it really depends on the reseller, but in most cases you have several accessories. Of course, this is the tracking device, and in here you can see that there are several more accessories like a charger, the USB cable. It actually comes with two batteries, another cover, a waterproof case, and of course its manual. In terms of its operation, you can open the device. As you see here, you install the SIM card, a battery, and according to the manufacturer, those batteries provide uptime of up to 12 days. Then the device has a series of settings that you can do by sending SMS messages to it. Anytime you want a location, you call this number, wait until you get a message that there was no response, and after a while you will get an SMS with the location information. Another option is motion detection. In this mode, every 3 minutes, the device checks if it was moved from its original location, and if it was, it will send a similar SMS message to its operator. There are many more options, including shaking detection, alerts on low battery, defining a list of authorized phones that can only communicate with it, setting a password, automated location reporting at a configured interval, real-time tracking of movement, and others. And in case you wonder, what this small SMS button is, it's a configurable option where you can make it send its location to a predefined phone number when pressed. Apparently, this is not a government level TTL technology. For example, it uses SMS messages, which is known to be an insecure and easy to intercept communications technology. And the use of cellular networks can be discovered with basic TSCM, technical surveillance countermeasure sweeps. Having said all of that, why would such a device be part of the spy collection? The reason is that there are several real-world cases where this exact device has been used by state and non-state actors for covert surveillance. When using an off-the-shelf product like this, as a nation-state actor, you have some benefits. For example, you can easily purchase it in almost any part of the world. It is harder to trace it back to a specific nation-state, thus improving the plausible deniability and its extremely low cost. To give you a practical example, the photo we used at the opening of the episode comes from the Greek Vice magazine. In November 2019, a device identical to this one was discovered concealed in the motorcycle of a 55-year-old man in Athens, Greece. This man had some anti-government ideological views. According to the target and the journalist, it was installed as part of an internal security covert surveillance operation. Apparently, there was never any confirmation or denial by the Greek authorities for this specific case. But it's a nice example of how a commercially available TTL technology can be used by state actors and how this helps in deniability. And since I brought up this example, it's worth highlighting that the operators in this case appear to have added an external battery to it and taped it with duct tape, probably to enhance its operational lifetime without a need for maintenance, which drastically increases the risk of compromise. In conclusion, commercially available cover tracking devices still have an important role in espionage. Although their main audience is private investigators and citizens, it's not unusual for nation-state actors to employ them too. Also, the fact that those cheap commercially available devices provide such capabilities in this compact size gives an indication of what government-only TTL technologies could be. So beware of your surroundings, because that small black box you notice in your vehicle might be a cover tracking device, maybe even a Chinese TK-102. Nothing is as it seems.